荣耀归普拉帕德。
哎，荣耀归普拉帕德。哎，苏比利罗帕布，您可以开麦。
你的父亲怎么样？
反正还在医院里。
还在医院里。
在治疗。对，在治疗。稍微稳定一些了。现在还稳定。
稳定哦，稳定一些。
对对，雇了一个看护的人员，然后在医院里陪护，晚上我就回来了。好的，谢谢 Good Day。那我们准备开始了，可以吗？
好。
Recording in progress。
Om Jnanatmarandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chaksurunmilitan Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishtaya Bhutale Srimati Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namane Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Pracharine Nirvisesha Shunyavadi Paschacha Desha Tarine Vancha Kaupata Rubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhaevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're on the Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 6, and we're on chapter number 10, which is entitled The Battle Between the Demigods and Vritasur.
我们现在所学习的是《圣典薄伽瓦谭》第十章，这一章描述的是半神人和维彻苏惹之间的战斗。
So the demigods had approached Lord Narayana, and he told them to go to Dadichi and get the bones from his body.
半神人去寻找了至尊主纳尔央纳，纳尔央纳告诉半神人应该去寻求圣人达迪奇，找他要他的骨头。
So with the bones from Dadichi's body, then Vishwakarma made a thunderbolt weapon and gave it to Indra.
用这个打地起身上的骨头 ，Vishwakarma， 然后用他这个骨头做了一个霹雳，把这个霹雳给予了半神 Indra.
So the demigods headed by Indra with this thunderbolt weapon, they were very powerful, and they were defeating all the attempts of the demons.
这些半神人就在 Indra 的带领下去寻求去找这些恶魔，跟他们较量，跟他们战斗，然后所有的这些恶魔都被这个他们的强大力量给击败了，就是在场的这些士兵们，因为这个武器非常的有力量。
The demons had used weapons like the tops of mountains and trees, but the demigods smashed them to pieces.
恶魔用山峰、树木把这些当作武器扔向半神，但是这些半神把这些被扔来的这些东西全部都砍成了碎片。
So we're on this chapter, nearly finished actually, this 10th chapter. And we're hearing how that because the demons are not devotees of Krishna, so they didn't have Krishna's protection in their battle.
这一章我们几乎快讲完了。因为恶魔他们不是至尊主 Krishna 的奉献者，所以他们在战场上不会得到至尊人格守神的保护。
So all of their different weapons, the different things they tried to use to defeat the demigods were no good.
所以这些恶魔所用的一切的武器 在战场上所用的一切的武器均将告以失败。
So the demons when they became hot, they lost their pride. They couldn't be proud anymore about fighting.
恶魔也不再变得骄傲，他们失去了他们的骄傲在战斗之中。
And instead, what they decided to do was they decided to run away from the battle.
取而代之的是，他们现在决定从战场上逃跑了。
Because they wanted to save their lives, they ran away.
因为他们也想保护自己的性命，所以他们就决定逃跑。
And they didn't even care about the leader. The leader was Vritasura.
他们也不在乎他们的领袖 Vritasura.
Because everything they'd done had been defeated by the demigods.
因为他们为之所做的一切全都被半神人所击败了。
So they thought, we have no hope to win the battle.So they thought, we'll just run away and save our life.
他们认为我们在战场上没有什么希望了，那么不如现在就逃跑，保全自己的性命为要紧。
So Vritrasura was the leader of the demons, and he saw that all these people who were supposed to fight with them, he saw them all running away.
Vritrasura 是恶魔的领袖。他看见在战场上这些恶魔准备逃跑。
And they were all afraid. They were supposed to be here. They were supposed to be heroes, but they became afraid.
他们本应该在战斗中成为英雄的，但是他们现在害怕了，竟然还想逃跑。
So Vritrasura, he was really a hero.
而 Vritrasura 却是一位真正的英雄。
And when he saw them all afraid and he saw them all running away, he just smiled and he spoke to them.
当他看见这些他的手下的这些恶魔部将准备逃跑，非常的害怕，于是 Vritrasura 微笑了，准备就开始对他们说一些话。
So he spoke words to them which were.Very much appreciated by thoughtful men.
Vritrasura 所说的这一席话被那些有思想的人深深的所欣赏。
Everything depends on position and the time and the circumstance.
一切都应该根据时间、情况以及特定的条件。地理位置、时间、条件。
So Vritrasura addressed, he spoke to these so-called heroes of the demons who were running away.
Vritrasura 正在对那些所谓的恶魔中的英雄对他们在说。
He called them by their names. Viprachiti, Namuchi, Pulomai, Maya, Anarya,Sambara, please hear me. Do not run away.
Vritrasura 在跟这些恶魔中的所谓的这些英雄在呼唤着他们。Vipachiti, Namuchi, Maya, Anarva, Sambara, 请听我说，不要逃跑了。
So Vritrasura told them.Everyone, all living entities who take birth in the material world will have to die sometime.
Vritrasura 给他们说，所有的在物质世界投身的这些生物，在一定的时候必定会死亡。
There's nobody in the world who found any way to avoid death.
没有任何人能够在这个世界上去避免死亡。
Even providence, destiny is not giving us any way to escape death.
即便天意也没有提供给我们一种逃避死亡的方法。
So we have to die. We can't avoid it.
我们不得不死，而且无法避免。
But if one can get promotion to the higher planets, and he will always and be always celebrated, if somebody is able to get promotion to go to the higher planets, then he has to die a suitable death.
假如一个人可以被或提升到高等的星系，那么他的死亡是死得其所。
And he will always be recognized. If he dies a suitable death, he will get a good reputation.
如果他能够死得其所的话，他会受到，他会获得很好的荣誉。
So any sensible man will accept. He won't mind. He will be happy to accept a death like that.
那么哪一个人不会接受这样一种光荣的死亡呢？
It's good to die a glorious death.
如果能够非常荣耀的这样去死，是非常好的。
If you just die on the bed, it's not very glorious.
如果你就只是躺在床上然后就死了，这不是什么值得荣耀的一件事情。
So in the Bhagavad Gita, we read Krishna talking to Arjuna, telling Arjuna to die on the battlefield is glorious.
我们在《薄伽梵歌》中看到主 Krishna 对阿尔朱纳说，如果能够在战场上死，这是非常值得荣耀的一件事情。
Tamal Krishna Goswami was taking care of Prabhupada in the last year of his life.
圣塔玛拉 Krishna Goswami 在圣帕帕的最后一年照顾圣帕帕的。
So he wanted to take Prabhupada to America again.Before he left the body.
在圣帕帕德要离开躯体之前，塔玛拉克什纳戈斯瓦米想把帕帕德带到西方，带到美国。
And he was telling Prabhupada how Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita to Arjuna that it's good to die on the battlefield.
而且他还引用了《薄伽梵歌》中主 Krishna 告诉阿尔朱纳，最好叫在要就是比较好的，就是在战场上死在战场上。
So to die on the battlefield is a glorious death.
因此，死在战场上是一件很重要的事情。
And Prabhupada agreed. Prabhupada said, "Yes, I want that benediction."
圣帕帕德说：“好，是的，我也想要那种祝福。
”I want to die on the battlefield.
我也想在战场上去死。
So we see Prabhupada preaching up to his last breath, dictating his books, even though he only had a few days left in the body. He was preaching, dictating purports of Srimad Bhagavatam.
我们看到圣帕帕德直到生命的最后一刻，他还在传播，他还在讲述圣典薄伽瓦坛的要旨。
So that's a glorious death.
所以这是非常光荣的死。
So Prabhupada explains, if by dying we can go to the higher planets, then that's good.
所以圣帕帕德也在这里提到，如果能够提升到高等的星系，如果非常荣耀的话，这种死亡是非常好的。
And you'll be famous after you die. If you're going to the higher planets, then you'll be famous after you die.
而且在你死亡之后，你可以提升到高等星宿，这是非常好的一件事情，名垂青史。
So any sane person, intelligent person, they will want to do like that. They want to die a nice death like that.
Sorry, Gurudev, who
any intelligent person will be happy to die a glorious death.
所以任何有智慧的人, 他们都希望, 都非常开心, 能够这样去死。
And then Prabhupada said, just like in the Bhagavad Gita, the same advice was given by Krishna to Arjuna.
神爸爸地说, 在《薄伽梵歌》中, 同样的建议也是由主 Krishna 给予了 Arjuna.
Krishna told Arjuna, don't stop fighting.
Krishna 告诉 Arjuna, 不要停止战斗。
Don't give up fighting.
不要放弃作战。
If you win the fight, you'll enjoy the kingdom.
如果你能够赢得战场上的胜利, 你将赢得整个王国。
And even if you die in the fight, doesn't matter because you'll go to heaven.
即便你在战场上死去, 你也不要紧, 因为你将被提升到天堂星球。
So Prabhupada said, everybody should be ready to die while doing service for Krishna.
神帕帕地说, 每一个人都要准备好去死亡, 在你从事, 对 Krishna 去做奉献服务的时候, 每个人应该要准备好自己的死亡。
We don't want to just die like cats and dogs.
我们不应该像猫狗一样的去死亡。The
animals like cats and dogs, they don't know the value of life.
像猫和狗一样的这样的生物, 他们动物, 他们并不知道生命的价值所在。
But human beings have a responsibility to make good use of the human life.
但是人类的人体生命, 人类他应该有责任去充分利用好自己人体生命的这个价值。
So they're meant to use that life for the service of Krishna.
他应该好好利用好自己的人体生命去用于对 Krishna 的服务。
So there are two ways to meet a glorious death.
有两种光荣的死法。
Both are very rare.
这两种方法都非常的罕见。
One way is to die while performing mystic yoga, especially bhakti yoga.
第一种方法是在旅行神秘瑜伽，或特别是奉爱瑜伽之中死之后死去。
And that way you control the mind and the living force.
在这种方法之中，我们人可以控制他的心意和生命力。
And you die absorbed thinking of Krishna.
在专注于 Krishna 的知觉之中而死。
And the other way to die, which is also glorious, is on the battlefield.
第二种非常光荣的死法是死在战场沙场上。
You lead the army and you never turn back.
你率领着军队，而且永不返回。
If you go back, that's not good.
如果你逃跑的话，这是不好的。
So these two kinds of deaths are recommended in the Shastra as being glorious.
这两种死法在经典中被描述为是光荣的。
So we're going to begin chapter 11 now, and it describes the wonderful qualities of Vritasura.
我们现在将进入到第十一章，这一章将描述的是 Vritasura 的光荣的品质。
Vritasura is a demon, but he's also a devotee.
Vritasura 是一个恶魔，但同时他也是一位奉献者。
Remember, he got cursed by the wife of Lord Shiva to take birth as a demon.
我们记得他是被主希瓦的妻子所诅咒而成为了一个恶魔。
But actually, his heart is devoted to the Supreme Lord.
但是实际上他的内心是一位奉献者，他是至尊主的奉献者。
Actually, this Vritasura is one of the great heroes of the Bhagavatam.
实际上，这一位 Vritasura 是博伽瓦坛的一位，博伽瓦坛里面的一位英雄。
He has such wonderful qualities of devotion.
他在奉献服务之中有非常美好、非常美好的品质。
Of course, seventh canto, next canto, just now we're on the sixth canto, but seventh canto we'll hear about Prahlad Maharaj. He was also born in a demon family, but he was a great devotee.
我们现在学的是第六篇，在第七篇里面描述的圣帕拉达马哈拉吉，他同样也出生在恶魔的家庭之中，但是他同样也是一位奉献者。
So we see the birth is not the...It's not the birth which stops us from being a devotee. We can be born in any condition and be a devotee.
从这里我们可以看到，并不是出生阻碍了我们能阻碍我们去成为一位奉献者。我们在任何的种族、任何的情况下都可以去成为一位奉献者。
Hanuman is a monkey, but he's a great devotee.
Hanuman, 他是一个猴子，但是他也是一个奉献者。
And Garuda is a bird, but he's a great devotee.
Garuda is a big bird, but he's also a great devotee.
And then we have the demons, people born in the demon families, but they're great devotees. Prahlad Maharaj, Bali Maharaj.
And we also heard many people who were born in the evil family, like Prahlad Maharaj and Bali Maharaj, they are also a great devotee.
And here, we're hearing about Vritasura, who has a very demonic body, but his heart is very devoted to the Supreme Lord.
在这里我们了解到的 Vritasura, 他的躯体是一位非常邪恶的这个很不得了的这个恶魔般的躯体，但是他的内心却是一位非常好的奉献者。
So Sukadeva Goswami is describing this pastime to Maharaj Parikshit.
Sukadeva Goswami 将为为 Parikshit Maharaj 描述这个非常优美的逍遥时光。
So he tells Maharaj Parikshit about how all these demons, how they were all running away from the battlefield because they were afraid.
Sukadeva Goswami 就给 Parikshit Maharaj 讲描述那些。恶魔他们是多么的害怕，想逃离战场。
So Vritasura, he was the leader of all the demons, and he tried to give them some advice.
Vritasura, 由于是这些恶魔们的领导，所以他准备给这些恶魔一些建议。
He wanted to tell them what are the principles of religion.
他想告诉他们到底。宗教原则是什么？
But these other soldiers, they were cowards, and they were determined. They wanted to run away.
但是这些士兵们，这些部下们都非常的胆小，他们非常想逃离战场。
And they were so afraid, they were so disturbed and so afraid that they couldn't hear.They couldn't listen. They didn't want to accept whatever Vritasura said.
而且就是因为他们都太胆小了，那个时候胆战心惊，他们甚至都听不进 Vritasura 所说的那些话。
And they didn't want to accept what he said.
而且他也不想，他们也不想接受 Vritasura 所说的那些话。
So the demigods, they were taking advantage.Of the good opportunity which they had.
这个时候，半神人就趁着有利的时机，他们准备做一些事情。
Previously, the demons had defeated the demigods, but now the situation was changed.
在先前的时候，这些恶魔是打败了半神人的，但是现在情况完全转变了。
Now the demigods are in control. Time is in favor of the demigods.
现在的有利时机，现在的时机是有利于半神人的，时空转换了。
So the demigods, they chased after these demons who were running away, and they were attacking them from behind.
半神人就追赶着这些恶魔，而且从背后攻击了这些恶魔们。
And the demigods were sending the demons far away. They would just get them out of here and get rid of them.
这些半神人就开始驱散恶魔，把他们让他们四处奔逃，让他们群龙无首。
It was like these demons didn't have any leader.
就好像这些恶魔群龙无首，就是。完全没有领导一样，把他们击溃了。
So Vritasura saw these demons, he saw their condition, and he felt very sorry for them.
当 Vritasura 看到眼前发生的一切，他感觉到非常的惭愧，非常的不好。
So Vritasura, he's the best of the Asuras.
Vritasura 是恶魔中的佼佼者。
And another name of Vritasura is Indrashatru, the enemy of Indra.
Vritasura 的另外一个名字是 Indrasatru, 就是 Indra 的敌人。
So he could not tolerate to see these demons go against all the religious principles by running away.
Vritasura 无法容忍这些恶魔违背宗教原则逃离战场。
And he saw the demigods also breaking the religious principles by attacking them from behind.
他也无法容忍这些半神人从背后去攻击这些恶魔的这种行为。
So both of them, they were both doing wrong. The demons were wrong and the demigods were wrong.
因此不仅是半神人包括恶魔他们都做错了。
So, Vritasura,got angry and began to speak to the demigods.
Vritasura 非常的愤怒，然后他开始对半神人说话。
He said to the demigods, he said, these demon soldiers have taken a useless birth.
他跟这些半神人说，这些恶魔生下来就是没用的。
They have come from the body of the mother just like stool.
他们从他们的娘胎里面出来就像屎一样。
There's no benefit to kill these people.
杀了这些人一点用处毫无意义。
They're running in fear. Why don't go behind them and kill them? That's no good.
他们非常害怕的逃跑着，但是不要从背后去攻击他们，这是不好的。
A hero shouldn't kill anybody who's afraid. You don't fight people who are afraid to die.
一位英雄不应该去杀那些害怕的人。
That is not good. That is not glorious.
这样的做法是不光荣的。
And if you kill people in that way, then you will never get to heaven.
如果你杀一个害怕丧命的人，你将永远不能提升到天堂星球。
So Vritasura was chastising both the demons and the demigods.
Vritasura 既斥责半神人，也斥责了恶魔。
The demons, they were trying to save their life. They were running away.
这些恶魔都害怕丧命，所以在逃跑。
And the demigods were trying to kill the demons from behind.
而这些半神人，他们竟然想从背后去攻击恶魔。
So both of them were acting very bad. Both the demons and the demigods were doing very bad things.
不管是这是恶魔和半神人，他们做的行为都是非常不好的。
When two armies come together, when there's going to be a fight, they have to be prepared to fight like a hero.
当两方军队要开始作战的时候，两方的军队的人都应该像英雄一样去作战。
A hero never runs from the field of battle.
一位英雄从不应该逃离战场。
He always fights face to face.
他们总是面对面的战斗。
And he's ready to give up his life. He's ready to die in the fight.
而且他也准备好了想要在战场上死。
But he's determined to try to win.
他的决心是要赢得胜利。
So that is how the hero acts.
这是英雄的做法。
But if you kill the enemy from behind, that is irreligious.
而如果从背后去杀死敌人，这是违反宗教的。
If the enemy turns around and runs out of fear of his life, then you can't kill them.
当你的敌人转身逃命的时候，你不应该去杀他。
This is the rules in fighting enemies.
这些都是在战斗之中的规则。
There's etiquette to be followed in fighting.
这些都应该在战斗中应当被遵循着。
Yeah, etiquette, Vaishnava li, right? Li.
礼节，礼节。
Oh. Okay, so there's etiquette in military science has to be followed.
这是军事科学的礼节。
So the two sides fight, they should follow that etiquette.
两方都应该遵循这样的军事科学的礼节礼仪。
So Vritasura, he insulted the demons who were supposed to be on his side.
Vritasura 也指责了他的这些恶魔们。
He said they're like stool of their mothers.
而且他把这些恶魔比作是他母亲的粪便。
Both the stool and the cowardly son, they come from the stomach of the mother.
粪便和胆小的儿子都出自于母亲的腹部。
Vritasura said no difference between them.
Vritasura 说他们之间是没有区别的。
So in Hindi poetry,There was a famous author. There was a great devotee who was he wrote beautiful poems. His name was Tulsidas.
在印度的诗歌之中，有一位非常有名的人叫 Tulsidas.
And he said in one poem, he said, both the sun and the urine, they both come from the same place.
他说，儿子和尿液都出自于同一个地方。
Because in order to produce a son, you have to pass semen. So both semen and urine, they come from the genital.
因为如果你要产一个儿，如果你想要一个儿子的话，你得产精液。因此，精液和尿液都来自于生殖器。
But semen will produce a child.
精液可以生产孩子。
But urine will not produce anything.
而尿液却不生产任何东西。
So, if a child is not a hero or a devotee, then he's useless. It's just like urine.
如果一个孩子既非英雄也非奉献者，那他也没有什么用处。他就像尿一样。
Better to have urine than a son, because the son is useless.
最好去有一泡尿，而不是这个真孩子。
So Chanakya Pandit also says, Chanakya Pandit, he was also a great moralist in the past, a long time ago.
Chanakya Pandit 在以前也说过类似的话。
He said, "There's no point to have a son if the son is not, if he's not, devoted to the Supreme Lord."
恰那克潘提这么说，如果 就是说既不光荣也不奉献给主的儿子有什么用呢？
He should, if he's not glorious, if he does, if he's not a hero and glorious, and he's not a devotee, then he's useless.
既不光荣也不奉献给主的这样的一个儿子有什么用处呢？
So,
没有什么用处。
The son who's like that is just like a blind eye.
如果这个儿子像这样的一个情况，那就像瞎了的眼睛一样。
Just like the blind eye, it gives pain, but you cannot see anything.
这样瞎了的眼睛只会给人带来痛苦，不会帮助人任何事情。
So sometimes having a son is like that. It just gives you pain. Doesn't give you any good.
有些时候的这个儿子的这个情况就是这样，他并没有给你带来任何的好处，只是给你带来痛苦。
So Vritasura is speaking to he spoke to the demons, now he's speaking to the demigods.
Vritasura 前面是在给恶魔在讲话，现在他准备在给半神人说话。
He tells the demigods, if you really have faith that you're a hero.
他对半神说，如果你们真的很自信，很有信心的话，你们应该是英雄。
And if you have patience, if you're patient in your heart.
如果你们在你们的内心深处有耐心的话。
And you're not ambitious for sense gratification.
如果你们对感官享乐没有任何的野心的话，
Then stand in front of me for a minute. Come here, stand in front of me.
那就过来到我的面前站立一下。
So Vritasura is challenging the demigods.
Vritasura 这个时候在挑战半神。
He says, come and stand in front of me and show me your skill, show me your strength.Let's fight.
Vritasura 在挑战半神，来吧，来到我的面前，展示你的技能，展示你的力量。
And if you don't want to fight, if you're afraid of dying, I shall not kill you.
如果你们害怕死亡的话，我就不杀你们。
Vritasura said, I'm not like you.I'm not so evil as you.
Vritasura 说，我不像你们那么邪恶，我跟你们不一样。
I'm not going to kill people who are cowardly or who are not willing to fight.
我不会去杀那些不想战斗的人，我也不会杀那些胆小的人。
So Vritasura said, if you have faith that you're really a hero, you're really brave, then come.Stand with me and we'll fight.
如果你们真的很英勇的话，如果你们真的很自信的话，那就到我的面前，让我们来战斗吧。
So Vritasura was angry and he was very powerful.
Vritasura 这个时候非常的愤怒，而且他也非常有力量。
So when the demigods heard him, they were terrified.
当半神人听到 Vritasura 这么说的时候，他们也非常的害怕。
They could see Vritasura was very strong. He had this huge body. He was very strong.
因为他们知道这个 Vritasura 非常有力量，而且他的躯体也非常非常的大。
And when he spoke, he would roar with such a voice that almost all living entities would faint just hearing his voice.
而且当他以他的这个声音去说话的时候，非常的响亮，去吼叫的时候，所有的生物体几乎都昏过去了。
So when the demigods heard Vritasura's roar, it was like a lion.
当半神人听到 Vritasura 在那里吼叫的时候，他们感觉像听到了一头狮子在吼叫。
And when they heard it, many of them fainted and fell to the ground.
当他们听到这个声音的时候，他们就昏过去了，昏倒在地。
It was like they had been struck by thunderbolts.
他们就好像被霹雳击中了一样，昏倒在地。
And the demigods, they would they were so afraid they closed their eyes.
半神人也非常的害怕，他们慌张的闭上了眼睛。
So Vritasura had his trident, he picked up his trident.
Vritasura 就拿起了他的三叉戟。
And he was so powerful that when he moved, it was like the earth would tremble.
Vritasura 非常的有力量，当他移动的时候，整个地球都在颤抖。
And as he moved, he would trample over the demigods underneath his feet. They would be trampled by him.
他在战场上移动的时候，将众半神都践踏在自己的脚下。
Just like when there's a mad elephant comes and tramples everything, trample all the bamboo in the forest.
就像一个疯象在森林里面走的时候，他把所有的东西、竹子啊，都踩在自己的脚下。
So Vritasura was like that mad elephant.
Vritasura 就像一头风象一样，就像那样的情况。
So Indra, he's the king of heaven. He was watching Vritasura. He could see Vritasura's anger.
Vritasura, 天堂的国王，他当时看到了所发生的一切，他知道 Vritasura 那个时候非常的愤怒。
So Indra has different weapons with him.And one of his weapons was a club. So he threw his club at Vritasura.
Indra 手里有不同的武器，他当时就拿着手中的大头棒扔向了 Vritasura.
So this club is very difficult to stop.
这个大棒，大头棒，巨棒难以被抵挡。
But when Indra threw it at Vritasura just caught it easily with his left hand.
当这个大头棒飞向了 Vritasura 的时候， Vritasura 轻而易举的就把它用左手把它给接了下来。
And then Vritasura, then he attacked Indra and he hit the head of Indra's elephant with that club.
然后 Vritasura 又拿着这个大棒反向一扔向了 Indra 的坐骑，大象的那个坐，这个坐骑大象。
And when he hit the elephant, he made a great sound on the battlefield. It's a great cry.
当这个大头棒击打到大象的这个头的时候，在战场上发出了一个巨大的声响。
So seeing Vritasura do this, how he attacked this elephant and hit the elephant with a club, the soldiers on both sides, they glorified Vritasura.
当 Vritasura 把这个大头棒砸向了大象的头之后，砸向了 Indra 的坐骑大象这个头之后，双方的士兵都荣耀都赞美了 Vritasura 的这一个举动。
So the elephant's name is Airavata. It's a famous elephant, the carrier of Lord Indra, was churned from the milk ocean.
这 Indra 的坐骑，这个大象的名字叫 Airavata， 它是来自于搅拌甘露之羊产生出来的。
So it's a very powerful elephant, but Vritasura's club, he struck it.And the elephant was feeling very great pain, and he was spitting blood from his broken mouth.
这个大象是非常有力量的，但是它被Vritasura的大头棒给击中了之后，口吐鲜血，非常疼痛。
Yeah, when Vritasura hit the elephant, it was like a mountain being struck by a thunderbolt.
当时的这个情景，打中大象的这个情景，就好像一个霹雳击中了一座大山一样。
And then Vritasura pushed the elephant back 14 yards.
而且当这头大象被击中了之后，这个大象往后退了14码。
And the elephant was in great distress, and he fell over.
而且这个大象在剧痛之中跌倒在地。
And Indra was on the back of the elephant. So Indra fell off the elephant fell down because of Vritasura's attack.
因为 Indra 是骑在大象的背后的，当大象被击中了之后， Indra 也从大象落了下来。
So when Vritasura saw this, that the elephant was injured and in great pain,Then Vritasura didn't attack anymore.
当 Vritasura 看到有这样的一个情况的时候 ，Vritasura 也再也没有，就是说暂停了他的攻击。
So Indra, when he saw how his elephant had been harmed, Indra was very unhappy, very worried.
当 Indra 看到自己的坐骑被这么伤害了之后，他自己也非常的不开心。
But Vritasura, he follows the religious principles. He didn't attack again.
Vritasura 他是遵循着宗教原则的，他再也没有继续乘胜攻击。
He could have attacked them and finished them, killed them, but he thought, no, it's not fair. Let them recover.
维彻苏拉其实在那个时候是有机会了结他们的，但是他没有这么做，让他想让他们康复一下，修复一下。
So Indra took that opportunity to heal the elephant.
在这个机会，趁着这个机会 ，Indra 就去抚慰这个大象，治疗这个大象。
Indra had some mystic power.And he just touched the elephant with his hand, and he cured all the pain and the injuries of the elephant.
Indra 有一些玄秘力量，他只是用手去触摸这个大象，就能够解决大象的痛苦，然后治愈他所有的这些伤。
So then Indra and the elephant, they just stood there silently.
然后英爪和大象都默默地都站了起来。
So Vritasura could see the elephant and Indra standing in front of him.
Vritasura, 看到了这个英爪和他的大象现在站了起来。
And Vritasura, he knew that Indra was his enemy because Indra had killed his brother.
维彻苏拉也知道 Indra 就是他的敌人，因为 Indra 杀害了他的兄长。
Indra killed that Vishwarup, who was supposed to be their priest and do sacrifices for them.
Indra 杀害了 Vishwarup, 因为 Vishwarup 应该是他们半神人祭祀之中的祭师。
But Vishwarup was making offerings for both the demigods and the demons.So Indra didn't like that, so Indra killed him.
但是 Vishwarupa 在做祭祀的时候，同时把这个祭品给了半神，又给了恶魔，而 Indra 并不喜欢他这么做，于是就把 Vishwarupa 给杀了。
So the father of Vishwarup, the father of the one who got killed by Indra, his father was a powerful Brahmana, and he did a yagya to produce somebody who would kill Indra.
Vishwarupa 的父亲，他的父亲是一位非常有力量的婆罗门。他的儿子死了之后 ，Vishwarupa 死了之后，他的父亲就通过一场祭祀想产生出一个能够杀死 Indra 的人。
But something went wrong with the yakya, and he didn't get exactly what he wanted.
但是在这个祭祀的过程中，他出了一些小小的错误，他并没有产生出他想要的那一个人。
So he got a demon. He got Vritasura, And he was Indra's enemy.
于是他就得到了一个恶魔，然后这个他得到了一个 Indra 的敌人。
But Vritasura's also a great devotee.
而且 Vritasura 同时他也是一位奉献者。
So Vritasura remembered how Indra had killed his brother very cruelly.
Vritasura 记得这个 Indra 他是如何残忍地杀害了自己的兄长。
Yeah, there was no fighting or anything. Indra just came there and he just cut off his head.
他们之间也没有什么战斗，这个 Indra 就只是跑到他的面前去杀掉了他的头。
So Vritasura was thinking about Indra's.Sinful activities.
Vritasura 就在想着 Indra 所做的这些罪恶活动。
So Vritasura was lamenting, and he was very upset. He began to speak to Indra.
Vritasura 非常的悲伤，然后就开始准备给 Indra 说话。
So he tells Indra, he said.Somebody who has killed a Brahmana, he said, the killer of a Brahmana is now standing before me, face to face. In other words, Indra killed a Brahmana. So Vritasura said, you killed a Brahmana, you're standing in front of me.
维查苏拉就跟英哲说，那个杀害了婆罗门的人，那个人就站在我的面前，就是英哲你。
And he said, you also killed your spiritual master. That person you killed wasn't just a Brahmana. He was your spiritual master. You asked him to be your guru.
那个你杀害的人不仅是一位婆罗门，而且他还是你的灵性导师。
And he was also my brother, and you killed him.
他不仅是一位婆罗门，是一位灵性导师，而且他还是我的哥哥。你竟然把他给杀死了。
And somehow now, by good fortune, you're standing in front of me, face to face, as my enemy.
凭借着某种好运，你现在就面对面的站在我的面前。
So you're very disgusting. You're very abominable.
你是非常可憎可恨的人。
Your heart is like stone.
你的心脏像石头一样。
And when I use my trident to pierce your heart, then I'll be free from my debt to my brother.
当我用我的三叉戟将你的石头般的心脏给刺穿的时候，我将偿还亏欠我哥哥的债务。
Vritasura says to Indra, he said, "You killed my brother, my elder brother, just so you could live in the heavenly planets."
Vritasura 继续给 Indra 说，你杀害了我的哥哥，仅仅是为了生活在天堂星球。
My elder brother, my brother, he was self-realized and he was without sin.
而且我的那个哥哥，我的那位哥哥，他是一位觉悟了自我的无罪的人。
And he was a qualified Brahmana.
他是一位合格的婆罗门。
And you had appointed him to be your priest to do the yajna for you.
而且你亲自指定他作为你的祭祀之中的祭师。
He was your spiritual teacher.
他是你的灵性导师。
And you asked him to do your sacrifice.
你叫他帮你做祭祀。
But then you cut off his head from his body.
但是你却把他的头颅从他的身上给砍了下来。
You did it just like one cuts up animals.
就像去砍一头动物的头一样。
So Vritasura is speaking very harsh words to Indra.
所以威舍苏拉用非常坚硬的话语对英卓说。
He's telling him the truth. Everything is true.
而且威舍苏拉所说的这一切都是真实的。
So he says to Indra, he said, "You have no shame."
而且，就威舍苏拉就跟英卓说，你简直不知廉耻。
You have no mercy.
你没有仁慈。
You have no glory.
你没有光荣。
And you have no good fortune.
你不会有好运的。
You don't have any of these good qualities.
你没有任何的优秀品质。
You lost all these things because you did so many bad sinful activities.
因为你做了太多的罪恶的不好的罪恶活动，所以你失去了所有的品质。
So you will be condemned even by the man-eaters, even the people who eat human flesh, the Rakshasas, they will condemn you.
即便是那些吃人魔那些 Rakshasas, 他们都谴责你。
So now I'm going to cut your body to pieces with my trident.
我现在将用我的三叉戟刺穿你的身体。
And you're going to die with great pain.
你将会在巨大的痛苦之中死去。
And even fire will not touch you.
即便是火都不想触碰你。
Only the vultures will eat your body.
只有那些秃鹰才会吃掉你的躯体。
You are by nature cruel.
你的天性就很残忍。
So if other demigods, if the other demigods follow you by attacking me, I'll do the same. I will also cut their heads.
如果那些半神人不知道我的力量在追随着你，我也不会对他们客气，我也会杀砍了他们的头。
And with their heads, I will do a sacrifice to Bhairava.
我将用这些头做一个祭祀给这个 Bhairava.
I will do a sacrifice for the other leaders of the ghosts also.
而且我也将为其他的鬼魂为他们也举行祭祀。
Yeah. So, Bhairava and the ghosts, this is the mode of ignorant worship, these kind of demons. Bhairava is the demigod of the ghosts.
Bhairava 是精灵，这些鬼魂的半神。
So he said, I'll offer your heads there.
我将把你们所有的这些头供奉给他们。
But then Vritasura said, but if you cut off my head with your thunderbolt and kill my soldiers, then I will take pleasure to offer my body to other living entities.
然而如果你在这场战斗中能够用你的霹雳砍下我的头杀死我的这些士兵，我也会非常乐意的把我的躯体献给其他的生物体。
There are animals like jackals and vultures, they eat human flesh.
有一些豺狼和秃鹰，他们是吃人的血的，吃人肉的。
The vultures eat in the daytime, and the jackals eat in the night.
秃鹰是在白天吃，豺狼他们是在晚上吃。
So Vritasura tells Indra that if you cut off my head, I don't mind. They can eat my body. I don't mind.
Sura 就说，如果你能够杀掉我，砍掉我的头，那么我一点都不在意，他们都可以吃我的身体。
Vritasura said, if you do that, I will get free of my karma.
威彻苏舍说，如果你能够这么做的话，我将免除我的业报。
And it will be my fortune, it will be my good luck to get the dust from the lotus feet of great devotees like Narada Muni.
而且我的好运将会是接受像 Narada Muni 这样伟大奉献者莲花足下的尘土。
Narada Muni had given Vritasura mercy in his previous life.
Narada Muni 在 Vritasura 的前世给予了，就是 Narada Muni 给予了 Vritasura 的前世给予了他一些仁慈。
Yeah, in his previous life, Vritasura was a demigod. What was the name? He wasn't a demigod. There was a great king who had many wives. He was a devotee king, and in his previous life, and at that time he got the mercy of Narada Muni.
在这个威彻苏舍的前世，他是一个奉献者的国王，然后得到了 Narada Muni 的仁慈。
What was the name? Okay, so.So maybe we need to stop there tonight.
Okay, 我们今天先讲到这儿，然后开始回答一些问题。
Are there any questions?
Yes. First question from Tapan Mishra Prabhu. 顶拜 Guru Maharaj 感恩翻译。请问 Vritasura 并不是半世人的灵性导师，那么他批评半世人是出于什么原因？他会不会承受批评半世人的业报呢？ Obeisance to Guru Maharaj, and I want to ask, Vritasura is not the spiritual master of the demigod, so why he criticized the demigod?Does he will response for this criticize any some karma for because of criticize the demigod?
Well, of course he's not their spiritual master, but at the same time he's pointing out.How they're not following the proper etiquette in fighting. They're not following the religious principles.
他虽然不是半神的灵性导师，但是他指出的是在作战之中的这些规范原则，他指出了他们不恰当的地方。
Yeah. He has to point out the mistakes that the demigods are making.
他需要指出半世人所做出的这些错误的事情。
So, Vritasura is a better devotee than Indra.
威彻苏舍甚至是一个比 Indra 还要好的奉献者。
That Indra, he, when he hears how Vritasura talks, Indra can understand that, oh, this is really a great devotee.
当 Indra 听到了 Vitrasura 所说的这一番话之后，他可以理解，哦， Vitrasura 他是一个好的奉献者，通常只有奉献者才会这么说话。
You know, they're on the battlefield and their enemies. So Vitrasura is pointing out that, you know, Indra, that what you people are doing, it's not right. You should fight properly, you should fight according to religious principles.
这个是在战场上，他指出了 Indra 的这些部下们，指出了他们的问题，告诉他们，你们做错了，而且你们应该去按照宗教原则作战。
But, of course, it's done in a very sarcastic manner.
Sorry, Guru.
You don't know that word, that sarcastic. Vitrasura is, you know, Takanbuchi, he's looking down on Indra.
Okay.威车苏拉他 并不瞧得起英转，他看不起英转。
So he's pointing out the defects in Indra's and his behavior.
所以他指出了英转的这种不恰当的行为。
Not just Indra, but the demigods and the demons, that they're supposed to be kshatriyas, they're supposed to fight according to the religious principles.
不仅仅是阴转，包括他的那些士兵、那些办事人们，作为叉锤啊，他们在战场上应该恰当的遵循宗教原则去作战。
But they're not following.
就像一个真正的叉滴滴去作战。
But they're not following the religious principles.
但是他们并没有遵循宗教原则。
So Vitrasura is disgusted with them.
Vitrasura 唾弃他们的这种。行为
so, he's telling them, he's just letting them know the truth. Let them know. They may be thinking they're big heroes, they're big, very brave, but they're cowards.
他们或许认为他们自己是个英雄，但是实际上他们都是胆小鬼。
So Indra wants to let them know.
所以威彻苏尔只是想让他们知道而已。
We should be willing to take good instruction wherever it comes from.
我们应该也有这种愿望，想要去接受别人的这种训示，无论这好的训示，无论这个训示是来自于什么样的地方。
Now, certainly, Vitrasura is giving good instruction.
当然，我们这里也很确定的是 ，Vitrasura 他给予的是好的训示。
Are there other questions?
Yes. Next question from Yuna. Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj, and dear devotees, please accept my humble obeisance, O Glory to Srila Prabhupada. From what I hear.Shani Devi is also the great devotee of Lord Krishna. Could Guru Dev tell more about it? Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj, 请接受我卑微顶拜，一切荣耀归帕帕。从我听到的来说 ，Shani Devi 也是一位伟大的奉献者，是主 Krishna 伟大的奉献者。能不能请 Guru 讲述他有关他的更多的一些 ？Hare Krishna.
No, I don't really know. It's just Shani Devi is one of the demigods, and people usually worship that demigod, you know, to avoid getting smallpox. That's usually worshipped in the villages, you know, because in the villages in India, many people would get sometimes smallpox, that disease, smallpox, you know that disease?
I don't know.
Smallpox, that's where the skin gets all spots all over it, you know.
Okay.在印度，我并不知道 Shani Devi 的特别多的一些情况。我听说他是一位办事人， 然后在印度有很多人崇拜他，特别是在农村崇拜他，因为 人们崇拜的他，崇拜他是想避免一种关于皮肤上的一种疾病，叫 Shandy Box 的这种疾病，皮肤上的一种疾病。
Yeah, so you often find temples of that deity in the villages, and it's for that purpose, to protect the people, to save them from that disease.
所以经常在乡村，在那些乡村的时候，你会看到庙里面有他的这个神像，人们祈求他的庇护，能够保护他们免于那种疾病。
But we don't hear anything in Prabhupada's books about Shani.
我们并没有在圣帕帕德的书里面找到更多关于他的描述。
Yeah.
Okay. Next question from 真真 Hare Krishna, 敬爱的 Guru Maharaj, 顶拜您，顶拜您甜美的莲花组，顶拜翻译主持人和所有奉献者。履行工作职责的时候，需要花时间、精力和心思在工作上才能做好。这些工作需要知识，也要花时间。还有和同事相处，应该怀着什么样的心态和同事相处？应该怀着什么样的心态去工作呢？怎样在这些事情和这些人之中总是看到 Krishna？ 我应该抱着奉献者应该比别人都做得好的心态去工作呢？工作吗？怎样做这些职业还能不依附？感恩 Guru Day， Hare Krishna， Hare Krishna。Dear Guru Maharaj, please accept my humble obeisance. And when I doing my work, it costs a lot of energy and mind intensity to work. Then the work will be well done. And when I deal with my friend during the work, also cost some times. So.In which kind of mood should I deal with my friend during the work? This is the first part.
Well, your friend is not a devotee, so it's a working friend, it's a relationship. You have to have these relationships, you work with people who are not devotees. So naturally you have to be careful how you associate.And externally, you should be polite and cooperative. Respectful.
这些同事因为不是也不是奉献者，但是呢，他也是你工作上的这些同事，在外在的你要很礼貌，而且尊敬他们，而且要和他们合作，这是在外在的。Hare Krishna.
Yeah. Yeah, what can we say? You have to be a human being. You have to work with people who are not devotees. You have to keep a friendly relationship with them. You don't know how to be friendly with people? You should know. You're working with people, you have to be friendly with them. You don't make them angry. You be sociable with them.
你是社交上跟他们保持这种很友好的关系，不要让他们愤怒就好。Then she asked, in what kind of mood should I...during the work, how can I see this everything and every work, every work?
You do your sadhana every morning. You chant Hare Krishna. You chant Hare Krishna every morning. You do your rounds and you hear class, or you read the book and you worship Krishna. You do a good sadhana every day, then you'll see Krishna in your work.
你每天早上做好你的 sadhana, 你每天念好你的圈数，你每天阅读这些书籍，这样你就能在你的工作中，在和人交往之中，你会看到 Krishna。
You have to learn to control your mind. You have to do your job. You're attached to work, you like money. You like to have that job.You need a job. You don't have any other job. So, you have to learn to control your mind. So every morning you do a good sadhana, then you think of Krishna throughout the day.
每天早上你做好你的桑德纳，这样你就在你的一天之中能够有好的知觉。
When you go home at night, then you offer your food to Krishna, and then you worship Krishna.
当你晚上回家的时候，你再继续给 Krishna 供奉食物，然后供奉给食物给 Krishna.
It's very simple.
你崇拜 Krishna, 这是非常简单的。
I don't know how many times I've told you this. I've told you this before. You have to learn to do proper sadhana. Then you'll think of Krishna in the daytime.
And then she asked, because we often heard devotees should do better work than other people. Should I work with this mood?
We work according to your ability. Do what you can.
到底奉献者应不应该怀着就是说比别人做的好的心态去做呢？麻烦姑姑的回答是。你做你可以做的，根据你的能力可以做的事情。
You can't do the impossible. Do what you can do. You have to know your ability.
你无法做到那些超出你能力之外的事情，你根据你的能力去做事情。The last she asked, how can I do my work without attachment?
You change the attachment to Krishna. When you become attached to Krishna, then you cannot stop attachment. You have to transfer the attachment.
关于你做你的职业如何不依附呢？布的回答是，你无法做到不依附。我们只是改变我们的这种依附。
You become attached to Krishna.
我们把我们的依附去依附到 Krishna 的身上。
That is.Actual detachment.
这个是真正的不依附。
Okay.
Okay. Next question, also from Papa Mishra Prabhu. Obeisance to Guru Maharaj. 感恩翻译。请问，当大头棒击中Indra的大象，为什么半神人也赞美这样的举动？Obeisance to Guru Maharaj. I want to ask, when the clubs attacks the Aravats, why the demigod also appreciate these kind of activities?
Because the elephant was so big and powerful.
因为这个大象也非常的大，而且非常的有力量。
So they were amazed that the demon was so powerful that he could damage, that he could attack, he could injure the elephant.
所以当这当 恶魔把这个如此巨大的大象给击倒了之后，他们也非常的惊讶。
We said that elephant was born from the ocean of milk. It was a very special elephant.
我们说这个大象是来自于牛奶，他们搅拌牛奶这个甘露之羊，所以这个大象是非常特别的一头大象，大象非常有力量。
Yeah.
Okay. Next question from Kirtananda, Nanda Devi Dasi. 亲爱的顾儒顶拜您，人年老糊涂冒犯奉献者，冒犯 Krishna 也会怪他吗？我们应该怎么做不管他远离他不履行职责吗？Dear Guru, I abase to you. Because if someone is very old and he can't remember, he's very old. Because of this kind of old, he do some offense to the devotee or Krishna. Does the Krishna will blame him?
If he offends a devotee, yes.
Yeah, because he's very old. The Krishna will not like him or...
Old age is no excuse.
年纪大不是借口。
Hare Krishna. Guru Maharaj.
Hare Krishna.
Kirtananda Madhaji, 他说的是就是年老了，然后他的神志不是很清楚，就是精神，可能无法控制，有的时候就会，说一些比较就不清醒的话语，可能有一些冒犯，就是那种冒犯，他不是说他心里头想冒犯，就像骂人啊，然后可能骂奉献者呀，但是他是一种病态。
So somebody has to take care of them.
所以有人应该去照顾这样的年纪大的犯糊涂的人。
Somebody is old and they talk like that. They talk without proper care and consent. Somebody has to be there with them to stop them and tell them not to talk like that.
应当有人去照顾这样的人。当他这样去说话的时候，有人去告诉他不要这么样说，不要这么去说话，去阻止他不要这么去说话。
And they should get them to apologize.
然后让他能够去道歉，对这样的事情怀着歉意。
Because even though they're old, they don't want to offend the devotees. It doesn't give you a right to go around offending people.
即便他老了，他如果做冒犯，这种冒犯，是不太好的。
So people have to learn. You know, if somebody's old, they have this problem, they know they have this kind of tendency, somebody has to be there, take care of them, and help protect them.
而且我们要，如果发现身边有一些人年纪大了，然后发现他有这样的毛病，那我们就得好好的注意去照顾他，不要让他出现这样的问题。
Is it clear?
这个清楚吗？
那么如果他在家里组织联谊，有这种情况发生的时候，是不是就不能在他家里联谊了？其他奉献者是不是就不应该来了？
Yeah.
So if these old people organize the association, should we not come to his association? Other people should not come?
It's up to them. Come at your own risk.
这个取决于他们，他们来，然后承担着风险。
Right? You have to be careful.
那么就得小心了。
You don't know. It depends how much people take offenses. Some people may be very offended.
而且我们也不知道这样的奉献者他会做出什么样多大程度的冒犯。有一些人的这个冒犯是很大的。
Now you do something unintentionally, you know, you didn't do it on purpose, then it's not going to be so serious.
如果你是不是有意的，那么他将那么这个结果也不会说特别的严重。
But it will depend on the circumstances. If somebody takes offense, somebody may get very upset, and it's a problem.
但是这个也是依情况而定的。如果有一个人他确实不是有意这么去做，但是其他人又很在意这个事情，那这就是一个很大的问题了。
So offending the devotees is very serious.
冒犯奉献者是严肃的事情。
Somebody's old, then it's not going to help their spiritual life if they say things which offend devotees.
如果有一些人年纪大了，他说一些不好的事情去冒犯，这个并不会有利于他的灵性的生活。
They have to be careful.
因此就得非常小心。
Bring people, you go to their house. First of all, the person's old, and he's not very, you're not very experienced as a devotee. It's not a very good idea to go to their home.
如果有人年纪大了，或者说容易出现这种犯糊涂的毛病，那去他家并不是一个非常好的决定。
Of course, he's getting some benefit because the devotees are coming to his home, so that's to his benefit.
当然，这个对于他本身来说是有一些好处的，因为他年纪大了，然后让奉献者去他家，他确实能得到一些好处。
But if they come to his home and then he insults them, then it's not very nice.
但是如果奉献者去到他们家，但是这个年纪犯糊涂的老人家去指责这些奉献者的话，那这并不很好。
Then they will say, "Well, I'm not going to come here again."
那么有些人就会觉得，哦，我再也不想来这里了。
Yeah. So.
好的 ，good day. 那么。还有就是，如果这位老人是自己的父亲的话，那么就这种情况是有奉献者提议，就是要把这个父亲送到养老院，或者其就是不能再这么服务他了，因为他一直在做冒犯嘛。所以这种情况我们应该就不赡养老人了嘛，就让他去安排其他的地方去。
对，所以要安排其他的地方，诊所。Yeah, better go another place. Better go another place.
最好是换一个地方。
如果送不出去，就只有他一个人可以照顾，那也没有办法，就得小心，是吗
？Yeah.
If cannot go other place.So, no other way. Just be careful.
Yeah, you have to be careful.
是的。
好的，感恩 good day.
Next question from Tejas Prabhu. Hare Krishna, 顶拜灵性导师和奉献者。下个月开始派出马拉松月，我们计划同时进行素食羚羊马拉松月。如何做好此服务？请求孤儒给予指导和祝福，谢谢。Hare Krishna, obeisance to spiritual master. Next month is the marathon of the distributing the books. So at the same time, we also plan to distribute the Mahaprasadam, the Prasadam Marathon. So how can we do this service properly? Please give us instruction and a blessing. Thanks, Guru Maharaj.
Well, I don't know how you're going to distribute the Mahaprasadam, so I have to know more about that before I could give you any instructions.
我不知道你应该如何去做好这个活动, 所以我得想一想在你做这个事情,
I've never heard before about a distribute Prasadam marathon.
我以前没有听说过派发Prasadam的这个马拉松。
I think you better to concentrate on the books first.
我认为你最好先专注于派书。
And after you distribute the books, then you can think about distributing prasadam.
在你派发书，先想专注于派发书之后，然后再想着去派发这个prasadam.
Be careful that you don't try to do too much.
要小心的是，就是说要注意的是，不要做太多。
You try to do too much, you'd end up doing nothing.
做太多有可能到最后会一事无成。 Next question?
Yeah.
Next question from 徐小元. Hare Krishna, 顶拜Guru和翻译。 给主戴花环之前，为了保持花的新鲜，会给花喷水，花环喷水。有的奉献者考虑到神像穿戴有水的花环会不舒服，建议少喷水。有的奉献者认为主是超然的，不同于普通人。如果把主当成普通人一样对待，会造成冒犯，请求Guru给予指导。感谢您。 Hare Krishna, basis to Guru. Before we give the garlands to the deities, we want to keep the garlands very fresh, so we put some water to this garland. But some devotees consider that if we put some garland, we give the garland to the Lord with the water, because this garland with the water, that garland will disturb the Lord and make the Lord uncomfortable. So he suggests not put water to the garden. But other devotees think the Lord is transcendental, is not from the ordinary people. So it's a little contradiction. If we think the Lord is ordinary people, if we think the Lord is ordinary people, is offense. So how should we do? Please give instruction, Hare Krishna.
Well, I don't want to get involved in this. It's a delicate issue.
我不太想涉及到这个里面的很细节的这个情况. That delicate issue.
Sensitive. I may say one thing and some other people don't like it. I don't want to take sides.
这个是有一点敏感的，就是说你们有一些人是这样的，有一些人喜欢那样。我并不给这个事情站队，就是说我并不想站到其中任何一边。Certainly,
you should be cautious. If you put water on the garland, if the garland's all wet, then you can't put it on the deity. The garland should be dry. You don't, just like if I give you a garland which is all wet, will you like to wear it? I don't think so. So the deity is also a person, and you should respect that he's the supreme person. You don't want to put a wet garland around the neck of the deity.
就像这个神像，它也是人。如果说我把一个有点湿的这个花环戴到你的头上，让你戴着，你会感觉到舒服吗？我相信你也不会感觉到舒服。神像同样也是如此。我们给神像， 如果带这个很湿的花环，我想他也不会喜欢的。
You cannot say, "Oh, Krishna's transcendental; it doesn't make any difference to him." That is not proper thinking.
你不能说哦，主 Krishna 他是一个超然的，他不会有什么恰当不恰当的反应。这不是你应该，这不是一个恰当的思考的方法。
You want to think how to serve Krishna as nice as possible.
你应该想着如何更好的。如何尽可能的好的去服务主 Krishna?
So the garland should be fresh, but it should not be wet.
这个花环应该是新鲜的，但是不应该是湿的。
If it's all wet and you put it on his neck, then all his clothes, his dress will all become wet also.
如果这个花环是有水分的，戴在他的脖子上，那么他的衣服也会变湿。
And the color from the flowers is going to stain the cloth of his dress.
而且花上的颜色也会沾染到衣服上，让这个衣服染色。
So you should be careful.
因此你也得小心。
So I've seen devotees, they spray a little water, but they don't spray much water, just a little water, just to keep the flowers fresh.
我看到有奉献者会给花喷一点点水，但是不会那么的多，只是让它保持新鲜。但是要这个花一定要保持干燥，但也要保持新鲜，又干燥又新鲜。
But I'm not an expert in deity worship, so I don't want to tell you this is right, this is wrong.
因为我不是在神像崇拜上非常专业的人，我也无法告诉你哪个是。这是正确的，或那是错误的。
Yeah. 下一个问题。
Okay. Next question from Vaishnavani. Vaishnavivani. Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj, please accept my humble basis. Vaitrasura is a great devotee, and it is amazing that the Lord Krishna is arranging to take some karma away in his demon body.How to understand this? Does devotee also have some karma remaining? Is it not that Vaitrasura made more karma in demon body? Thanks Guru Maharaj for your wonderful lectures. Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj, 请接受我卑微的顶拜。Vaitrasura 是一个伟大的奉献者。非常令人惊讶的是，主 Krishna 拿走了他的这个业报，即便他是一个恶魔的躯体，如何去理解这一点呢？是不是奉献者还存留了一些业报？是不是说，Vaitrasura 就是说 Vaitrasura 在他的这个恶魔般的躯体里是没有业报的？还是 Krishna？
Yes, devotees we have some karma because we haven't fully surrendered to Krishna. If we fully surrender to Krishna, then we don't have karma.
我们现在奉献者确实是有一些业报的原因，是因为我们没有完全的臣服 Krishna. 如果我们能够完全的臣服于主 Krishna, 我们是没有业报。
If we strictly followed all the principles of devotional service, then we don't have karma.
如果我们能够严格的遵循经典上的规范原则，我们是没有业报的。
But if we're not fixed, if we're not very steady, not very safe, not very strict in following, then we do get karma.
如果我们并不稳定，也并不是那么严格的。完全的追随这些规范原则，那我们是有业报。
So usually there's a little bit of karma there left.
因此，通常情况下确实是有一些业报。
We see just like the fan, the electric fan. Once you turn it off, it keeps running. It still has some momentum. It didn't stop yet.
就像我们举的那个例子，这个风扇。当我们把插头拔了之后，它还会继续转一会儿，因为之前它是转得很快的。把插头拔掉，它还会继续转一会儿，然后 后就停掉。
So we have still a little bit of karma, which we're just finishing off.
因此，在我们完全结束我们的业报之前，我们还有一些业报停留着。Next question from
What was the second? What was the second part of her question?
He's amazing about how to understand the Lord Krishna arranging, taking, Vishwasura have a demon body, but I think he don't have karma, taking his karma, the Lord Krishna taking his karma.
Well, no, he was given that demon body to finish off his karma.
Okay. 他是主 Krishna 是给予他这个恶魔的躯体，然后结束他的业报。
Yeah, after you see in that demon body, he went back to Godhead.
你会看到他在这个恶魔的躯体结束之后，他回到了灵性世界。
It was his last birth.
这个是他最后一世。
So it was just to finish off his karma, so he could go back to Godhead.
他只需要结束掉他这个业报，然后他就可以回归受身。
So we see some demons like that in Krishna Lila also. They came, Krishna killed them, then they went back to Godhead.
我们看到一些恶魔也是这样情况，在 Krishna 的逍遥时光之中，有一些恶魔来了之后，然后主 Krishna 杀掉他，这些恶魔就回归受身。
Okay.
The next question, I think.Is from Sumukhi Gopika Dasi. Dimbai Maharaj, Dimbai 翻译和所有的奉献者，请问敌人是 Indra， 为何不针对 Indra 而要伤害无辜的大象呢？另外一个问题，打仗之前讲很多的理由，是宗教原则，讲打战之前讲很多理由是宗教原则规定的吗？为什么为不说什么直接打不行吗？First question he asked, obeisance Maharaj and all devotees, because the demon is Indra, why not just attack Indra, but Vishwasura attacked his elephant, Airobot?
Well, the elephant is a carrier, so the elephant plays a big support for Indra.
因为，这个大象是 Airobot 的，这个大象是 Indra 的坐骑，它给了 Indra 很大的支持。
Just like when they're fighting in the Kurukshetra war, often they'll get the chariot and they'll kill the horses which are pulling the chariot, and they'll break the chariot to pieces before they get the person who's on the chariot.
就像在库鲁之野战场上。他们在打仗的时候，首先是把马，然后马车给砍成碎片，把马也打掉，然后让这个人落到地上之后，然后再把他杀掉。
When they have the, so Indra was on the elephant, it's a big support. You come in on the elephant, people get out of the way, you know, they get trampled by the elephant. If they don't get out of the way, the elephant just tramples over them.The elephant's coming, you don't get in the way, you keep out of the way.
这个大象非常的大，而且它来的时候造成了很多的震动，引起很多很多它底下的人就逃跑了，所以他就把这个大象先搞定。
So Vritasura is showing his strength by attacking the elephant.
Vritasura 也通过攻击大象、击打大象来展现他的力量。
Pushing back the elephant, injuring the elephant. People were appreciating.
让这个大象。
They were appreciating. They thought, "Who is a very great warrior?"
把这个大象击倒在地，然后让他口吐鲜血，然后还要退14码，这些都让他赢得了这个赞誉。他是一个非常伟大的战士。
Elephant, so And this elephant, this is the best of elephants, the strongest of elephants.
这个是大象之中最有力量的大象。
And Vritasura injured it, pushed it back.
Vritasura 伤害刺伤的这个大象，就是伤害了这个大象，然后让这个大象退往后退了十四米。
So the elephant will be very careful in the future.
所以这个大象之后也会对威彻苏拉特别的小心。
Yeah. Second question.
Then he asked, before the fighting, and they talk so many things about the reason. It is also from the religion rules.
Yes.
Why not just the fighting?
Yes, well, because he's a devotee, you see. Vritasura is a devotee, he's a great devotee. And he's instructing Indra on the principles of Kshatriyas, the etiquette of warfare.
是的，就打仗之前讲这些，确实是来自于宗教原则的规定，而且 Vritasura 他是一个奉献者，他在告诉 Indra 他所做错的这些事情，在提醒他。
Just like Lord Krishna and Arjuna, Krishna spoke Bhagavad Gita before they started the battle.
就像 Krishna 和 Arjuna, Krishna 在库尔之野战场之前给 Arjuna 讲解了《薄伽梵歌》。
Every night they would stop.
而且每一天晚上他们都停战。
And they would talk about what happened in the day.
他们都在讲述着这一天到底发生了什么事情。
Just like when they have basketball or football, they have halftime, and they have breaks, and they all go off the field, and they talk, and they discuss with the coaches and trainers.
就像我们的足球比赛、篮球比赛，他们有中场休息，然后还有临时休息，这些都是叫讲到底应该这个原则、规则等等这样的一些具体的要该说的事情要说好。
So similarly on the battlefield, Indra, Vritasura took time to enlighten Indra.
同样的。在这个战场，在这个战斗过程中，威彻苏拉也想启迪，也想给予这个因转给予他一些启示。
It's the nature of devotees. They want to speak about dharma, about religious principles, about duty.
这是奉献者的本性，他就想他的本性，他的天性就是想讲述一些关于 dharma。关于职责，关于宗教，关于这些的一些话题。
Next question.
Prabhu give the last question.
We didn't finish all his questions. That first, that last one there. There was more.
Yeah, this Sumukhi Gopika question finished. And the next is Tejas.Hare Krishna, 感谢孤儿的指导，确实应该先专注于派书。因我们本身是素食协会，派书马拉松月是发动更多的企业赞助支持我们，使我们将爱心素食灵粮如水果点心派给他们，或者春节期间再举行可否？Hare Krishna, thanks Guru's instructions. Thank you. We also think we should distribute the focus on distributing the books. But because we are vegetarian association, shall we distribute some prasadam during the Spring Festival?
Yes. Very nice.
就春节期间举行可以非常好。
It's nice if you if even when you're distributing books, you can take some prasadam with you, and you can give people something. You know, maybe you have a sweet or a biscuit or something, and you can give it to them and tell them this is spiritual food.
嗯，如果你在派书的时候也给予别人一些素食，告诉一些点点或者说一些这样的 prasadam 给予别人。说这是灵性的食物，或者说等等一些介绍，这也是非常好的。就是派书的同时，然后也给别人一些小的 prasad。
Just like when we do programs, after the program we distribute prasad.
就像我们在做节目之后，也会派发 prasad。
The only problem is that sometimes people can easily get distracted. Instead of thinking about distributing books, they just start giving away prasadam.
嗯，这个唯一的这个我前面讲的这个事情，就唯一的这个问题，就是说人们有时候会慢慢的就是偏，就是侧重点就慢慢变成了派发prasadam。我不想变成这样，就是侧重点别搞错。
Of course, if you have prasadam, it's easy. You can give it out to people. People will take it and like that. But you know, I don't know if they get any spiritual benefit. They may take the prasadam, may not eat it. They may throw it away after you give it to them. You don't know what they're going to do with it.
嗯，就是当别人接受了你这个prasadam。沙等之后，他有可能没有吃，有可能就扔掉了。如果是这样的这个情况的话，他们不会有真正的好处。
嗯。So you have to be cautious about just how you distribute prasadam.
所以这一点你要想清楚，你到底应该怎么样去派发普沙等。
That's why we like to give prasadam when they come to the temple. When they come to our center, then it's convenient and they sit down. After they've chanted Hare Krishna, then they can sit down, they can take prasadam.
这就是我们之所以让别人来到我们的庙宇或者我们的中心给他们prasadam的原因。他们可以来到我们的中心然后坐下来，然后我们给他prasadam，他们可以我们可以看着他们吃掉这些prasadam。
Okay. No more questions.
Yeah, no more questions.
Okay. So, thank you all the devotees for questions.And thank you for listening.
感谢所有奉献者的问题，感谢大家来聆听。
Okay, Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai.
Jai, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Go back to Vrindaki.
Jai.